Hello. Good morning. Good afternoon. Good evening. I'm greeting you from where you are watching from. So I am Master Chris Graphics. So this is my page. I deal on auto cartoon. I'm using Autodesk sketchbook. So in this video, I'm about to show you how you can actually sketch a human hair. How you can sketch it and detail it, everything you need to know, the step by step how you can sketch the hair, detail the hair. So please, I want you guys to watch this video and learn. So the pen and the pencil I'm using, they are all there. I'm going to indicate it here now for you to see. So please, if you really want to learn this and you are serious about it, you need to have patience and watch this video from beginning to the end, and make sure that as you are watching, you are practicing it, you practice it so that you will be perfect. Because if you keep on watching without doing anything, you are only watching a television. So as you are watching the video, if you are serious, you have to download the app from your Google Play Store. The name of the app is Autodesk Sketchbook. So you have to download the app, make sure you install it. So there's nothing hard inside the app. Once you download it, you import the picture. So after importing, you can see the features there. I'm going to make a video to show you how to use the Autodesk Sketchbook. So for now, today we are going to learn how to sketch a human hair with ribbon, how to draw it. So you are going to see them. I'm going to indicate all the pencil I use in this video so that you can see. So please guys, I'm begging you people to please subscribe to my YouTube channel. I promise you guys that I'm going to be uploading more videos, more things you need to learn, how to add the color on the hair, how to add the skin color, how to paint the lips, the eyes, how to smudge, how to set your pen. So everything I'm going to be dropping it on this page. So please endeavor to subscribe to my channel, please, so that I will be able to have encouragement to be uploading more videos here. Please, if there's anything you really want to know about Autodesk Sketchbook, just comment it down there. I'll reply immediately. My WhatsApp number is 081-51-58-4798. So you can ask me any question on WhatsApp, or you comment on any video you do not understand, then I will put you through. Thank you guys. Let's go over. Yeah, first of all, you have to import the picture into your Autodesk sketchbook. Then you create a new layer. Then on the main, the reference picture, you reduce the opacity so that you can see what you are doing. So now I'm using the brush 7 to sketch the foundation of the hair. So just follow me on this and see how I do it. You can see how I'm sketching the air, so you just have to follow it like that. I'm not saying I'm perfect, but at least I'm trying my best. This is my own idea, how I understand how to do it. So nobody is perfect. If you have any other idea on how you think it is simple for you to get what you want, so you can easily sketch anyhow you know is easy for you. For me, this is how I understand it. So it's not a must that you must follow this step, the purpose of this video is for me to show you some idea on how to go about it. For those of you that doesn't know how to do it, so this is the video. So if you have any other idea, you can use to sketch this air. So I'm filling the inner side of the line now. That's the main air. So I'm just filling it now. That is one side of the air. So I'm going to sketch the other side. As you can see, I'm just following the lines of the hair, so that I will not miss anything. I just want the hair to look like something like that. I know this video is going to be very long, so I don't just want to fast forward it so that you guys will understand what I'm doing, all these steps. If I want to forward this video now, you may not get all the parts, everything I do, so I'm not going to forward it, though it's going to be very long. So I'm not going to forward it. I'm just going to make it two parts. This one now is number one. So the part two is coming. So I finished sketching the foundation of the hair now. So I'm just trying to fill it up, make it look good. Just trying to fill it up now. So the next thing I'm going to do now, I'm going to pick my digital brush. Then I'll just give some stroke to make the hair look good. For now, I'm going to clean off some parts that has gone out of the hair. So I'm going to use my hard airbrush. So as you can see in the video, I'm just clean it out to some parts that I see that is out of the hair. So just watch carefully, you will see what I'm doing. So after cleaning off the edge, so I've created a new layer now. So I'm going to pick my digital brush now. So the size I'm using now is 1.5. So I know you may be wondering why I'm doing this. Most of people don't do this, so for me, I'm just using this particular brush to make the hair look real, to show the strands of the hair. So that is what I'm doing now. Like as you can see here, I'm just trying to show you that there is hair there. So just follow me up and see the ending of this tutorial. this video is really taking time, but I just want you to have patience and watch it to the end so that you get what you want. So that is it. Just try to make it look real. So now I am going to import the color palette that I created. So I forgot to video this color palette when I was bringing out the color from the main hair. So I'm just trying to color the main hair now. So just watch what I'm doing. I've duplicated the main picture. So I unseen the down one. To unseen it now, then the upper one I reduce the opacity. So the sketch layer I've locked it, so I'm just going to use this color to fill up, to change the color from black to this other color now. Before you can get this, make sure the foundation layer, the black layer, this one that is in the middle, make sure you lock it. You can see the key down. Make sure you lock it so that you can be able to fill up with any color you like. So now I've created a new layer. I'm going to pick the second color now. So just watch and see what I'm doing. I'm going to pick my digital brush. So the size is going to be 3 something or 2 something. So let's use 2 and see how it will go. So the reason why I take this second picture up is for me to see the reference, how the slants of the hair goes. So I'm going to draw the lines based on what I see on the reference picture, as you can see. So this is what I've done. So in this particular area now, I'm going to use this digital brush and the soft airbrush. So this is the area I'm going to use the soft airbrush. So you clean up the edge. Just clean the edge. So this is what we are going to do around the hair. So you create another layer. So why we are creating another layer is that we don't want to use one layer so that it will not affect the previous one that we have drawn. So if you are going to use one layer, it's going to be very difficult for you, because as soon as you are drawing this second one, now when you want to clean the part that you don't want, it will affect the first one. So that is the only thing, that's why we are going to be using many layers. Just watch and see what I'm doing. I know this first layer you may not really see it very clear, but there is something there. Just look it carefully, you will see. So I've just merged the layers now, so that the layer will not be too many. So once you create a layer and you get what you want, you have to merge it to the down one. Then you create another one above them and continue your work. Make sure you create a layer on every part that you want to draw, so that you will not mix everything up. See what I've just did. In order for me to get this area, I have to flip the picture downward so that I can move my finger to a direction. So you have to follow the reference and see what to do, and as in just follow everything you see on the reference, okay? Please just make sure that you are creating a layer on every part that you want to sketch. Don't sketch everything on one layer. If not, you are going to lose everything you are doing, because the one that you have sketched and you know that is good for you, if you sketch another one on that same layer, when you want to clean, or maybe you made a mistake, so when you want to clean, you will definitely clean everything. So you have to be creating layers on it so that do not affect the previous one you have done. So after you have gotten what you want, you can merge the layers and continue like that, step by step, till you get what you want. Please don't do everything on one layer, it's going to be very difficult for you. Please, for those of you that are new on my channel, please, if you find my video helpful, please just help me and subscribe, like my video. And this is my first time of doing a voice recording, so I would like you guys to tell me how is it, so if there's any improvements so that I can improve myself. This is my first time of doing a voice video recording, so because most of my subscribers have been telling me they don't understand it without voice notes, so I have to do this for you people. Please also help me to like my video and subscribe, okay? So like what you have seen in the video, everything I do, I always create a layer, then after everything I will make it to the previous one. If you want to do everything on one layer, like I said, you are going to miss it, so you have to create a layer on everything you are doing. Thank you for watching, thank you for your time, I really appreciate you. As you can see, guys, everything I do, they have their own layer. It's only after doing it that I will now merge it with the other ones. So every step you take, make sure you create a layer for them. Even the skin, when I'm going to smudge the skin, you see the way I do it. Everything has their own layer, so that if you make any mistake, you can easily correct it without damaging your work. So everything you do, they must have their own layer. About this app, Autodesk, that we are using to do our artwork, I so much like the app because this app has many layers that you can create about 28 layers before they can tell you that you cannot create again. So before you create up to 28 layers, you must have finish doing what you are doing. So you cannot do everything on one layer. And the good part of it is that you can merge everything. You can merge what you are doing. Like the way I'm doing now, I create, I merge, I create, I merge. So there is nothing too difficult about this app. It's a very good app. So you have to create your layer. Make sure you create your layer. Don't work on the previous layer. Create a layer, then you can merge it to the previous one. So like I said, this about creating a cartoon or artwork, all these things need time. If you don't have time for this, you cannot learn it. So if you really want to learn this work, like if you really want to know about doing this artwork, you need time. You have to give it time, because for me, I almost do artwork every day with this app, every day. But when I was learning it, it was very difficult for me. At the time, I gave up, so I didn't continue again. After some time, I have to start up again. After I paid many people to teach me online, even people that are around me, so I paid them. But at that first time, I didn't get what I want, because I was trying to get everything at once. But at the time, I discovered that I cannot really get what I want if I want to rush, so I have to take it step by step. So thank God today, at least I can handle some work. I can deliver work. I've been making a lot of money from this app. So I'm telling you now that if you can create chance to do this, then you will gain from it. So right now we are going to apply the second color. So that one will be on a different layer, as you can see. I've just applied the second color now. So just follow me on this, see what I'm doing. You don't have to rush. Just step by step, you'll get what you want. That's why I say you don't have to fast forward this video when you are watching, so you will not miss any step. So this is what we are going to do till we get the actual thing we are looking for. Step by step like this. How to create a layer, you do what you want. Create image. That is the only thing you do. The secret about this is for you to know to look the reference picture carefully, and you know how the direction of the hair goes. Then follow it like that. There's nothing difficult about it. Just look on the hair. Anyhow you see it, then you draw it like that. Then you get what you want. As you can see, we are getting it gradually, so no, there is nothing difficult inside. It's just for you to follow this step. As you can see, we are getting it little by little. So guys, I would not like this video to be longer than this, so we are going to end this part one here. So please don't go, stay to see the part two of this video. You know, we still have two more colors to add, so don't have to go, just stay and watch the end of this tutorial. I believe you will have something to learn inside, so don't go. Please, if you have found this video helpful, please don't forget to subscribe. I'm begging you in the name of God, help me to subscribe. Please, I'm just a beginner. As you can see, I don't have much subscribers, so just help me to subscribe. God bless you. Put this thing serious, take it as your main serious thing, and I believe you will gain from it. Because today I am learning from it. Like seriously, I did not know that I'll be making money from this. A lot of people have been asking me to cartoon picture for them. They have been asking me to make a frame for them. Like, I've been cashing out big time. So subscribe to my YouTube channel and I will show you how to frame your work after printing. I will show you how you can frame it. I will make a video so that you can learn how to make your own frame, how you can make your customer frame and gain money from it. Please subscribe. We are going to end this video here. Thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. Thank you for your time. Please watch out for the part 2 and the ending of this tutorial, and I believe you will like it. Thank you.